On our deeper dive, we're going to be looking at Pastor Ryan's previous sermon last Sunday on the fact that people are the problem. And this is this relationship lie that builds up when we start believing that other people are the problem. Pastor Ryan, towards the end of his sermon, said this: "The way we stop tearing down others and rejecting this lie is humbling ourselves before the Lord. He gives more grace." When I was thinking through this and kind of thinking through how God works, I couldn't help but think of Paul. And Paul in Philippians tells the Philippian church that if anyone has any room to boast in their own righteousness, that he does. And this is what he says. This is Philippians 3, verse 4. "Though I myself have reason for confidence in the flesh also, if anyone else thinks he has reason for confidence in the flesh, I have more." Paul ends up going through this and he kind of gives his resume of what he has done in order to that he should receive righteousness. He says in verse 5, "He was circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel. He's of the tribe of Benjamin. He is a Hebrew of Hebrews. He is, as to the law, he is a Pharisee. As to zeal, he is a persecutor of the church. And as to righteousness under the law, he is blameless." Okay, but what we see here is as Paul continues in Philippians, his heart changes from, "I had all these steps of everything I needed to do," to, "I had hope and I had righteousness in Jesus." He says this, "But whatever I had, I counted it as loss for the sake of Christ. Indeed, I count everything as loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Jesus Christ my Lord." You know, when we are comparing ourselves to others, when we are seeking our own righteousness, and we look at it as anything other than Christ, it's easy for us to look at other people and say, they are the problem. The beauty of the gospel and the beauty of Jesus is that Jesus is what gives us our righteousness. And I think oftentimes that we can see in our relationships, we are just as broken, we are just as unrighteous, and we need to focus on God's grace towards us and towards the people around us, that we often create this lie that other people are the problem. We have to first come to Jesus. We have to first recognize that Jesus is what gives us our righteousness. Our resume does not live up. And so when we're comparing others to our resume, it still does not live up. And that's the gospel.